I got for selling me clothes, something for selling me blanket. If ever I list for the soldier again, devil shall be me sergeant.
Right, good morning, ladies and gents, and Sunday, covert spot, and we have a first time for Mr. Bruce.
Hello.
Second time for Gerry.
Hello.
Yeah, it being a bank holiday weekend, some people can do the Sunday or the Monday, so may well be coming over here again tomorrow. And at this point, first jobs, get a brew on, and I'm going to have a bit of posh coffee with the percolator, the Esbit percolator that Mike Smith gave me. So hopefully I've got all that set up right. And for the first time, I'm using these just for, as opposed to Hexi, the quick fire firelighters, and you can just get two boxes for a pound at the pound shop, which I did yesterday, just to give them a try. And only thing with that so far is it seems to be a bit smoky, but yeah, it's not really going to bother me too much. So I think that's it, is the coffee's in the top, the water's in the bottom, and hopefully I'll get posh cowboy coffee in there.
Looks good. Take a little while to boil though,
wouldn't
it?
I think it should be reasonably okay, mate. Obviously need a windshield. Yes, but Bruce has got some very interesting kit we've not seen before. Have a decent look at that later on, mate, yeah.
Some of
your wet form and stuff.
Dump pouch. Me mittens.
Yeah, it's very nice, mate. Very, very nice.
Bottle hanger as well.
Yeah. I'd like to have a decent look at them, mate.
Yeah, no,
so that's all the stuff you're doing yourself and that as well, isn't it?
Yeah,
saving a few bob, and we like that, don't we? Gerry especially likes saving a few bob, doesn't he?
Oh.
Right, anyway, ladies and gents, I'll see you later after I've had some coffee.
That's
yep, she just went, didn't have enough time to get the camera on there, mate, yeah.
Well, but I lift it off.
Yeah.
Get off. Yeah, I wish you boil it dry, so yeah. That's the problem. Then.
Yeah. But yeah, that's done me a nice postcard. Cheers there for that, Mike. I appreciate that, mate. But I think I've come to the conclusion there, you know, them fire lighting things, not really Hexi. They're okay for lighting fires, but it's just too sort of suited up in it, mate. There's better stuff than that, so next time I'll be using Hexi. But yeah, that will certainly make good fire lighting stuff, as we were talking about, eggs, you can crush that up and that, mate. Yeah.
They don't smell too bad, though.
No.
Hexi just smells like piss, doesn't it?
Yeah. It's a while since I've had Hexi.
Yeah,
nice one, so I'll get a brew on then. Ah, Jerry was just been doing some wood carving. What are we making this? Is that some sort of gladiator, Spartan type?
Yes.
Killing device?
No. It's just a bag of shit, though.
No.
Just that's how
more of a black you got there,
yeah,
mate.
Yeah,
isn't
it? Yeah.
Quite a nice little knife there. A lot of people speak well of them, don't they?
Mm.
How much did you pay for that? I can't remember, mate.
I got that a few years ago now for about 38 quid. I think they're a lot more now, actually.
Yeah.
But yeah, really good little knife.
Knife, yeah. I like the old Mora, isn't that, mate? Yeah.
Mm.
A lot of people speak well of the old Mora knives and that.
Yeah. Bushcraft blank.
Yeah. I had to put a little one out with me today, like. Just,
yeah.
But yeah, I think we're just sitting around really chewing the fat, mate, aren't we? Having a few brews. Yeah. I'll get some scoff on in a minute. Got a new little stove thing I want to try out.
Shooting a breeze.
And it don't matter where you go, you can't get away from aircraft noise, can you?
That's it.
Because I'll start cutting some of this away later on and just rebuilding up.
Yeah, just want to cut some of that back.
And where have you been, sir?
What? I went for a wee.
Yeah, give it a little chance to have a dive. You see that tree there, mate?
Yeah.
That's it, it's come down here. From the old Storm Katie or whatever it was.
Oh, right, yeah.
But it's really just landed in the right place.
Yeah, it keeps everything a bit covert.
Yeah, so I'm just going to cut a few bits and shove it there. The only one thing there, there was about four or five of us here. You can't have too many people there, so that makes sense.
No.
And Mike Smith was sleeping right there.
Oh, was he?
In one of them hoop
bivvy
bags he had, like, so, yeah. But certainly the old foliage is up, and I'll say we've just got a perfectly natural screen around here. But it was a fairly solid tree as well, mate, wasn't it? There was obviously something wrong with it, but...
Yeah.
So what are you doing there, mate?
making a spatula. I've got my pen out of the fire just to mark my edge out. Where the centre of the wood is, the strong bit, it's left a ridge there.
Yeah, so that's going to naturally lend itself to that.
So I'll flatten that end off, make that sharp, saw in there, knock those sides off, whittle it a bit, spatula.
And what wood's that, mate?
Sycamore.
Yeah, because you're up on your woods, and you know
what. Yeah, some of them.
some of them. So I'll have a couple of bits of that, let it dry out, and I'll do some.
You better keep it green.
Yeah?
Yeah, easier to carve when it's green.
Yeah
definitely.
Because that's the only thing my missus won't allow me to do in the front room. Carving. Strangely enough.
She's a very accommodating woman. There's plenty of things I won't be allowed to do in the front room.
No, she don't mind me doing my sewing. Where's what you said, oh, if you take the machine upstairs, oh, then I'll never see you and all that sort of kit, like, yeah? But like I say, I've got to have a bit of a... bit of a clear out of all the gear, because I get projects going and all that sort of kit, then I go on to something else, like, so it can be a tidy mess at times.
Missus won't let me bring other women home,
you know. They're funny like that.
Yeah.
I don't know, they must.
You're not doing that as a front room. Oh, come on, love. It's my hobby.
Yeah, yeah, it's always it's good to get the disclaimer on on camera.
I didn't realise you were filming.
Oh, you know me, mate. You know what I say? Oh, I don't do editing. Unless specifically asked
what
for.
What happens on YouTube stays on YouTube.
On YouTube, yeah.
Whatever.
No, but just on that, lady, that's, I'll take it out in a minute, but yeah, Beardy Clam said he was flogging this. I think it was a something ridiculous price, you know, lovely for 12 quid, so I got it off him, and it was an American genuine issue butt pack. And I was sitting there thinking, I'll tell you what, I reckon my 5-litre water container will fit in there, and it does look a treat. I've got a little pouch which I've put on the Alice Pack bit there, and that's got me soil water filter. But what I'm going to do with this is an ongoing Mac project, is I'm probably going to make a cover for it. I want the water filter in there and a Milbank bag to sit at the bottom. I want to do a little patch so I can at the top of the new one if I do it. It's going to have, so I can put like Steri tabs in there. But these things, well, naturally lend themselves to a haversack. They're a good size. You can pick them up reasonably cheaply, and it's American Alice butt pack. My water container, 5-litre one, fits in there. Vertical, and don't waste water, that's wrong, but yeah, so I mean, it works there, there's nothing wrong with that. But I see myself when I get a few moments, get that list down, make myself a proper little cover for that. And obviously it's 5 litres of water, so having a strap on it and something you can hang it up with is a good idea, I think. And that just kind of works there, so that's going to be an ongoing tightwad project. I think I'm going to make myself a proper cover for that, and whatever happens, there's going to be something so I can carry it in like that. You can carry 5 litres by hand, but yeah, but not for ages. So that's another tightwad. But if you don't know what the old Alice pack is, obviously I'll get it off there and show you the water container inside. But they're good bits of kit if you can pick them up. So that's your potassium.
That's your potassium, yeah.
Just doing the customary fire.
Yeah, I'll grab the camera. Oh, now we've got the glycerin. Now I don't know quite how much of this to put in.
Put it all on.
All of it?
Bung it all in. Yeah, that's what she needs, the money.
Alright, here we go.
Now it's down to the quality of your potassium.
Is it?
Yeah, now stir it in with a bit of stick.
Drink.
Do you see the one Mark did from my giveaway?
I'm purple.
I don't know, I think you made it. Is that all of that?
No, it was. Gloopy, like that.
Yeah, It does usually take a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
We'll come back to it when it starts moving. But brake fluid works as well. And some people say brake fluid's better.
Yeah, that's got glycerin in it as well.
It's not that hard to get hold of either, is it? Because glycerin in that, yeah, you have to...
Potassium perpanganate is a bit of a bitch. We can get it in Tesco's, cake glycerin. Antifreeze will do it as well.
Yeah. Come on, you bastard.
Sound like Rob.
This is certainly one I wouldn't rely on.
But no, he says he's a good...
Oh, here we go.
Here we go. So that was 2 minutes there, mate.
Whoa.
Ooh, that made me jump a bit there.
Get some kindling light, quick.
Yeah, I'm covered with fire.
Maybe just a little one. Yeah. If you'd have said, like, I'd have got a brew on.
Nah. Ooh, that was good.
Right, well, mate, yeah, around about 2 minutes that was.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, job done.
Okay, that was about the right amount,
wasn't it? Yeah. Yeah. Don't think the charcoal's going to work.
Continuing on with the fire making theme.
Ow, sticking in my hand. I can do it with a bit of char cloth easily. Come on! Go on, I'm freezing to death here.
There we go. That's it. There we go, nice one, mate.
Right, see if we can transport that and get it on the burning the cramp board. That'd be good. I don't think it's going to set fire. I think the cramp ball's a bit too fresh.
Yeah.
It needs to dry out.
And it's drying out more, mate, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's still...
You get that proper hollow sound when they're dry, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, well, no, but the old, nothing wrong with that char cloth, wasn't it, is
there? Nah, char cloth.
I think it's a little bit strike, because you made that, didn't you?
Yeah, there is a video on it.
Yeah. That's nice, mate.
Quite made like a little pouch there to keep the cramp balls in, because... Yeah. And a bit of birch bark.
Yeah.
And drying out the
fungi. I got some of that at home. It should be dry. I'll try and bring that down tomorrow and have a go with that.
Dry out and get a spark on it, and then it'll.
David fears that the fire bug will be here, and I've yet to see him.
He'll sit there smoking away for
ages. Yeah,
keep the bugs away.
Yeah, he'll. I haven't seen nothing he can't set on fire. It's a bloody arse on his ears. But I'm quite liking this satchel you got here, mate. Actually, I'm just like checking over your kit to see what, you know, I can nick like, you know. That's quite nice, mate.
Keeping an eye on you.
Yeah. Nice. And I think that's just a nice size as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good for, you know, like a day bag. But
yeah.
You're never going to get a sleeping bag in it, but...
Oh, no.
Underneath, you can put a bit of paracord and get a tie blanket on there.
Yeah. It's nice, mate. It's nice, sort of softish leather as well.
A little light hammock, perfect for it.
But even I like that, mate, because it's, you know, it's oldie worldy, isn't it? You know? Yeah. Traditional, like.
Let's see if I can get anywhere.
And we're having some manly target practice now.
See if I can get anywhere even close.
Oh, that was
that went
close.
Too far, mate, eh?
Get some more ammo.
We can cut that and edit in. We'll just go near it and throw a stone at it.
What, you mean, like everybody, like everybody else does,
throw
you mean?
A brick, yeah.
suppose.
Oh!
Glanced off
there's
it.
A bit of dust there. Dust!
Dust! Spent most of the time getting the band straight.
Yes.
Oh, nice yes.
Shot.
Oh, that's captured for posterity, mate.
You got him right between the eyes.
Did it all in my tin.
Has that gone out the other side as well, mate?
Yeah,
very nice. Well. Yeah. Oh, you got that right in the minge. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. So I've got.
Yeah, have a crack.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind. Where's the ammo?
In the bag next to the little cup.
It's not really focusing, mate, but yeah. Makes a good
run, Forrest, run!
Oh, yes! Got one back.
Oh, you got your back as well? Nice.
Don't hit the forks.
Hey?
Be careful about the as you tilt it.
What do you mean?
No, so it's like if you're looking down as you aim, if you tip it like that, as you fire, it's going to bang.
Oh, yeah. I see, right.
And take a big chunk out of your forks.
Oh, yeah. That's all right, that's not mine, so.
Somebody did that quite recently, didn't they? Can't remember.
Yeah. But when you're using someone else's slingshot, never hit their forks.
No. Yeah.
They'll never talk to you again.
Oh, fucking hell. Are you sure? Is that a promise?
Yeah, yeah. You got me Laplander sheath that I wet formed.
Yeah.
So with a wet forming, all I did was cut a bit of cardboard out. That's that rough shape, then wrap the whole thing in cling film so it makes this a little bit looser, otherwise you're never going to get it out. And then
see, that's a little tip there, mate. I wouldn't have thought that. Yeah,
see, and it's, and if you're doing it with a knife, you've got to wrap it in cling film anyway, otherwise your knife's going to go rusty.
Yeah.
And then nail it down, and you've got to, like, keep forcing it, nail down one side,
yeah,
and then force it over and get your grooves in, get it roughly right, then nail down the other side, put a few slots in the bottom, so you, that's the hardest bit to form.
Yeah.
Then force it all around, just with a teaspoon or a wooden spoon, something like that. You can get the special forming tools, but, you know, we're talking about bodging stuff, so.
We're talking about saving a few, Bob, mate.
Yeah, damn right. And then I've stitched it round there, and I've just folded that. The top, there's a bottom piece of leather there, fold it back round on itself, and that's your belt loop there. So keep it simple.
Yeah. Keep it stupid, it works, mate.
That ain't gonna fall out.
Yeah. And you've that's a nice little bit of kit, mate.
Yeah. Turned out really well, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, not bad.
But I've done a wet formed axe head as well, I haven't got that with me.
That's nice, mate. So we're just having a little
I've got me Wild Ginger Bruce dump pouch.
Yeah.
Which is pretty standard for a dump pouch. A little leather button on there, and then you've got a nice big pouch, so if you're foraging, you got your bag there for just for gathering tinder and
nice
mushrooms and stuff. What other goodies we got? I've got me stainless steel.
I do like that, mate.
Stainless steel bottle carrier, so you've got a little popper on there so you can get it out. And stitched at the bottom, stitched at the top. Top's just looped back round onto itself. Yeah. And I've dyed the bottom black and wetted the leather to try and fade it up. I don't know if that really shows up very well.
It does, mate. I quite like that as it goes, yeah.
And then you've got a little cover on that. So you can put that in the fire. And some of these keyring things hang up. Boil your water and stop it from freezing.
Well, I'll tell you what, it was cold when we went to that other place we were just talking about. David stuck his, it was what we used in the morning for his brew, but stuck it in the fire, in the 1 litre bottle, put it in the Nalgene, neoprene cover, and that was his hot water bottle. And I'll tell you what, it was a bloody good idea, mate.
Yeah,
whack it in your sleeping bag 15 minutes before you go in there,
Definitely.
That's something I'm going to do next time,
That's a good idea.
No, this is like the first sort of a pouch I made, which was... I've done it wrong, really.
Did you make that, mate? I just assumed that was, like the old World War II or Swiss Mauser pouches, mate, I saw it on the floor there.
But it's the stitching down there, where I stitched up and stitched back again, getting the bottom of that was an absolute pain. But this is just my camera case.
Yeah.
So I've got my video camera in there, and there's some lamb's wool just glued inside.
Or a fast starter should you need it.
Yeah, and just made of velcro, just sealed with Velcro. So it's kind of lost its shape a little bit to what it used to be.
Oh, I don't think it's... I'll tell you what, mate, it's... when I saw that on the floor there, I did take a picture of it, I think. I just assumed that was the mouse up, you know what I mean?
Oh, the little ammo ones?
Yeah.
That, I sort of copied one of them, that rough shape, yeah. But it's bigger.
Yeah.
It's a bit bigger, but I made it to, just to take my camera to keep the damp and a few knocks off of it.
That's really nice there.
Yeah.
And the lever, you bought that, mate?
I got the lever at the bushcraft show, but it's really thin. It's only...
Yeah.
1.5, 2 mil.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's the first lever thing I've made. Actually, was the.
Well, that's quite impressive.
We got loads of layers in it because it's quite a big handle and a heavy old knife.
Yeah.
And I've wedged it all. Yeah, I should have wet formed it, but this lever's a bit too thick to do it.
Yeah.
I've sort of done it a little bit.
But it certainly goes in there, mate. That does the what knife's that, mate?
That's the one I made. With 0 pence.
Yeah.
And the bushcraft blacksmith.
Yeah.
My brother got me a bit of Damascus steel for my birthday.
Yeah.
I've
got to say, mate, when I first saw that, I thought that was one of them Tops knives or the SE whatever.
Yeah. It sort of went to copy that because I put the finger trowel there so you can choke right up on it and get in close for carving and stuff, and then you've got another grip there.
But that's Micarta scales on there, mate. Did you
yeah, see them? No. I bought these off of Bushcraft Trade Post ages ago, and I had them knocking around. I'd give them to Keith, and then when I was looking at making the handles, he went, "Actually, these would be perfect."
Yeah.
I thought, "Oh, they look a bit small," but once I put them on there, I was like, "Yeah, you're right." And then I've just got a little lanyard on there in case I put it down and can't find it.
Yeah, and again, as we were saying there, bright colours, mate. Yeah,
shocking pink.
Yeah. It's like with the Laplander.
Laplander. Yeah. I've had a Laplander go and mismatch, as we talked about earlier on, but I found it in the bottom of my burger, and I knew it's unusual that I don't sort of put my kit away, like. But again, yes, it drops down, mate, yeah. Mm. I've got some yellow tape, I was just going to put some yellow tape on mine, just so it will stand out a little bit, because any fool can lose their kit.
That's the lanyard Big Martin made me.
Yeah, he's brilliant at lanyards.
What else we got? I've got my gloves, but I've stuck a popper on them, so they'll fit on your belt. So you've always got them with you, and you're not going to lose them.
I'm just going to come back and get that belt look,
So just really simple bit of webbing,
yeah.
Couple of poppers on it. But I've done a male and female, so you can actually pop them together as well.
If
you haven't got your belt with you.
Just
to chuck them in the bottom of your bag together, it saves emptying your entire bag. You always find the one, you don't find the other, you know. Like pairs of socks.
Oh, it's got some nice kit there, mate. There's some nice style leather work. Because he puts a lot on the pictures up that come up on the side there. And often put little comments because Tim Tank Tracks, he's doing some really bloody lovely work, isn't he?
Yeah, he is.
He's getting the hang of that. Yeah. But that, mate, no, seriously, you said all that's. I genuinely thought that was one of the older.
Yeah, it's.
Mauser ammunition type pouches.
That's all my bits and bobs. Well, I made that fit inside a zebra billy can because
I say hard, mate, but I always find that a right pain to do is to make the circle.
Definitely. Well, you can see there,
just pulled it in a little bit. It's just a pain at times, to be perfectly honest. I'd only sort of do that if I had a definite reason that why I wanted a circular one, because there's always something you want to throw in there.
Yeah.
Make it a bit solid.
Well, I was trying to make like the Sammy pouches. Yeah, because those are stitched round like that,
yeah.
And with an extra panel. This is Outdoor Life of Brian one.
Yeah.
I got this off of I'll remember his name in a minute. Urban Dodger.
Yeah.
In his giveaway competition, but that's a little coffee pouch.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dead good, but that's when that's done up. It's a nice round little thing, so that will fit. In my zebra can, and then that fits just on top of it.
Yeah, that's fine, mate.
But that's just kind of coffee and tea, ketchup, HB sauce.
You rubbed off from McDonald's.
Yeah, earplugs. What else we got in there? Mints.
That's just nice, mate. They do some nice old, and it's real rustic looking and that, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, so true.
Yeah. And don't get me wrong, it's like, not perfect, you know, from because one, it costs you the money, it costs you, make your eyes water, and two, It's always better when you've made something, mate, isn't it?
Yeah.
And again, see, like the next one of these you make will be 10 times better than this one, because it's all a learning experience as well. Like,
The thing is, when you're starting leathercraft, it takes so long to do it.
Yeah.
It takes ages.
Yeah.
By the time, if I think, you sort of sketch out a few ideas.
Yeah.
And then kind of think what you're doing, then you make a pattern, have a little play with the pattern and think how it's going to work. Same with the way you do your material, you know?
Yeah. But no, that's the dog's watch it, mate.
Yeah.
I love it.
It's just something you can keep on your hip. Because when you're outdoors, you've got to be drinking all the time.
The time, yeah.
What bottle is that, Bruce? It's an AliExpress, like £8 or something.
Yeah. But yeah. You can buy it, go outdoors for 23. You know what I mean? When they put their mark up on it.
Yeah, exactly.
Because I've got a 2-litre bottle, mate, that's exactly the same.
But I just searched stainless steel bottle and that came up.
Yeah.
And it's got a hanger on it.
I've got.
The only thing you're going to damage on it is there's the rubber in there, in the lid. So obviously, you're not going to boil it with the lid on anyway because it'll explode.
Yeah.
But it's just sort of. You could just put a carabiner on that, but I didn't want to lose the neoprene cover.
So. No, that's one, mate.
Thought were belt and braces.
What about the neoprene cover? Where did you get that from?
Came with it. Yeah. I think it was like an extra quid and you could have a cover for it.
Oh, there's loads of neoprene covers, mate. I've got one for the 2-litre water bottle. AliExpress, mate, about £2, something like that. Yeah, that's for the 2-litre ones and the 1-litre ones. I always like that ramming water bottle, mate, just to stop things dinking about, if that makes sense. No, I always like to have a little finger and forage in people's kit when they first come along, mate. Yeah, because you've made some really nice stuff there, mate.
Yeah, got me collection of books as well.
Oh, yes.
Trees, mushrooms, nuts, seashore, and food for free. So, foraging book.
Yeah.
Seashore, that's actually really good because it goes from rock pools to backwaters, beaches, but a lot of this stuff is edibles.
Yeah.
And the fish and
trees,
obviously we know what trees are, mushrooms we know what them are, and knots.
Something
I've got to practice.
Yeah, me too, mate. And if you see one of them knocking about or somebody comes up in the trade post, just drop my name in. Certainly the knots one.
The Collins gem books, they're not expensive.
No.
And then that nice size to
that you can bring out with, yeah.
Stick in your pocket, yeah.
So you can just sit there and have a little read.
This one I normally carry with me.
Yeah. Mm. They're nice as a reminder. I wouldn't use them.
Right, ladies and gents, we're all packed up, ready to go. Cheers for coming over there, Bruce, mate.
That's right.
You know where we are next time, mate. And obviously, Gerry, you know, it won't be any time, mate. Because you don't live that far, mate, unless I was Martin.
This is a bit closer than...
It's just getting everybody together all the time. It being a bank holiday weekend, people are going to turn up that can do the Monday, couldn't do the Sunday and that night, you know.
Yeah.
But it's been a lovely day.
Beautiful.
So apart from doing a few brews, I haven't done too much bushcrafty. We've been chatting and chilling, which is all part of it and that as well. So ladies and gents, on that point, I'll say ta-da. Nice to see you over, Bruce and Gerry.
Yeah, no,
and take care to everybody.
Yeah.